Something about beer that Aussies just love. Pale ale, strong stout, or my favourite, the talented Maggie Beer.
Very good.
Yeah, despite not having formal training as a chef, Maggie Beer has cemented her place as one of Australia's favourite food personalities.
Now the cooking expert will be back on our screens, finally, along with some familiar faces in the great new series, The Great Australian Bake Off. Maggie Beer joins us now live from Adelaide. Maggie, welcome to the show. There's the traditional damper or pavlova, but the big question is, are Aussies big bakers?
Look, the bakers are just, they were fantastic. The most amazing group of people. The diversity, the energy, it was a wonderful, wonderful time.
Oh, great. And Maggie, you've got the band back together. How does it feel coming back to the baking shed with the team after 2 years?
Well, it was lovely. I mean, working with Matt and Claire and Mel, it's like a family. Even the crew, most of the crew, there's such a sense of joy in the whole thing. And laugh, there's so much laughter. Mm.
Maggie, you're a trailblazer in the industry. We love you. But what advice would you give to a budding young cook who is self-taught, similar to yourself?
Well, I guess my advice would be start simple and practice and perfect it so your confidence is such that you just want to grow to the next one. So, you know, don't try and do too much too quickly, but practice and know that no matter what, you're having fun. That's the most important thing.
That's great. Well, I'm really excited about this season because this season the bakers are so diverse from their heritage to their life experience. That's what we like hearing when we see this as well. Mm. When first meeting the contestants for yourself, was there anyone who really piqued your interest?
Oh, well, I mean, so many because, as you said, the diversity. But there was the exuberance of Nerman, the joy of blessing. Each one of them had their own their own fire in the belly. I loved them all.
I understand, Maggie, that there's going to be a nostalgia week where contestants will include flavours from their childhood and upbringing. What would your nostalgia bake be?
Oh, I think it would have to be like golden syrup dumplings or Neenish tart.
Oh, Neenish tart.
You're too young to know about those.
No, I'm a Neenish tart guy. Yeah.
He's in. Back in your childhood again, yeah. He hasn't grown up. He loves it so much, he won't grow up. Maggie, in the UK, Celebrity Bake Off, it's hugely popular. We like it in Ireland too. I always used to watch it. Mm. Who would be your dream celeb to cook with?
Can I have a choice between two? Either Barry Humphries, who lives in London, or Daniel Craig. How's about that?
Wow. No, we're just getting a... my producer said you can only choose one.
You have to limit to
one. You can only choose one.
Oh, Daniel Craig.
There it is. Push comes to shove.
Now to answer some of your viewer questions. Maggie, are you ready?
Let's do it.
Yes, yeah. Yeah, let's get that. First off, Maggie, Jeez. James has asked, do you have any suggestions for a simple summer treat I can whip this Australia Day?
Oh, what about a prawn sandwich?
Yes.
You know, for me, it might be a blue swimmer crab because I'm by the sea, but everyone can get prawns. It's so Australian, but sourdough bread and a mayonnaise you make yourself and some rocket and just make it a real, a very casual, very tasty, wonderful thing. Why not?
Yes.
Oh, there you go. You're on board with that,
eh? Yeah, yeah. Do you mean when you make the mayonnaise like your own little seafood sauce, Maggie?
Oh, well, I'd make a mayonnaise and put in some tomato in the mayonnaise. Oof. The seafood sauce is easy too, but... I prefer a mayonnaise, so you can have your seafood sauce with it.
Oh, they're both winners.
Hey,
I love this question. This is from Lee. Lee says, what is your all-time favourite meal?
Oh, my all-time favourite meal. Mm. Oh, my all-time favourite meal is sea urchin. Just piles and piles of sea urchin, either just had raw or perhaps over some beautiful pasta with some extra virgin olive oil. And Nothing else.
Wow. Oh, wow. So you just eat them, what, obviously they're taken out, and
yes,
then what, just served
yes.
on...
It what? Is my... I just slurp them, you might say. No, that's not very ladylike, is
yeah,
it?
Yeah, yeah.
I just truly, it's my favourite food in the whole world.
Wow.
Oh, wow. I've never been so hungry. This is great.
She's the first person I've met that's not Kiwi that loves sea urchins. All my Kiwi mates will eat sea urchins until the cows come home. And I just, it's got a very, it's a quiet
urchin-y
taste. Yeah, it's a very urchiny.
Yes.
I tell you what isn't a quiet taste, meatballs.
It's irony, but it's buttery and sweet and wonderful, earthy.
Maggie, answer this one. We'll hear from Karen. Karen wants to know, how do I cook meatballs without them breaking apart?
Oh, that's easy. You've got to slap them. You've got to, on the side of your bowl, you have to emulsify the meat. You know, you might have a little bit of breadcrumb and egg, a little bit of Dijon mustard too, just a spoonful, and get it in your hands and have a big bowl and slap it against the side because the meat has got to emulsify. And if it's super, super cold, it will be better.
Okay.
Ooh.
Yeah, okay, there we go. Now, this is an interesting one. Catherine asks, when making caramel by heating sugar, are you allowed to shake the pan?
Ah, well, look, you know, if you're having trouble making caramel, the easiest way is sugar and water at a low temperature. Don't try first with just sugar. So sugar and water, low temperature until the sugar dissolves. And that way you really don't have to touch it. You just... keep it low to middling and let it do its own thing. Sometimes I will swirl it if I'm concerned about it as it comes together, but let it go till it's really deep, deep golden or it's too sweet. You have to almost go one stage short of burnt for it not to be too sweet.
Oh, yes. Great.
I'm a caramel boy.
So don't touch it.
Don't tell you if it makes it that long, yeah? I absolutely love caramel, and I love you, Maggie. Thank you. The Great Australian Bake Off premieres on Thursday at 8:30 on Lifestyle. Maggie, it's always a pleasure. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you, Maggie.
It's my pleasure.